Let's work through a volume by slicing problem. Here are the directions. Find the volume of the solid whose base is the region bounded by y equals x squared and y equals x, and whose cross sections perpendicular to the y-axis are squares. So to start this problem, we should go ahead and sketch the base of the region, which we're told is the region bounded by y equals x squared and y equals x. So let's just draw some rough sketches of those functions so we can get an idea of what this base looks like. So y equals x squared, of course, is just a basic parabola that goes to the origin. And then y equals x is just a line with slope 1 that also goes to the origin. So something like this. So we can see then our region of interest here is this region bounded by these two graphs. Okay, but we actually have a three-dimensional solid here. And the way that this three-dimensional solid is formed is by these square cross sections that sit on top of this base. So we're told that we have cross sections perpendicular to the y-axis. So if they're perpendicular to the y-axis, those cross sections are going to be going in this direction, right, in the horizontal direction. And so if you want to try to picture this solid, you're going to have squares sitting on top of this region and coming out of the page, and the base of those squares is going to be in the direction I've shown here, right, perpendicular to the y-axis. So how are we going to calculate the volume of this solid? Well, there's a standard way of doing these kind of problems, these volume by slicing problems, and the way we compute the volume is by integrating the formula for the area of one of the cross sections over some interval. Now, in this case, we're going to want to integrate with respect to y. So I'm going to be integrating some area function a of y dy over some interval c to d. And I can actually go ahead and show that interval on my graph. It's just going to be the y values over which this region spans, c to d. Now, as to why we're integrating with respect to y, I'll explain that in just a second. Okay, so a of y then is simply the area of a cross section. So let's spend a few minutes trying to come up with what that formula should look like. So here, my cross sections are squares. So the area of a square is simply side squared, or I will write s squared for now. So what we need to do is we need to come up with an expression for the length of the side of these squares. So let's go and look back over at our graph again. And let me actually maybe zoom in on this a little bit. So the side of any one of these square cross sections is going to be determined by the length of these green lines I've drawn here, these horizontal lines. So how would I find the length of one of those lines? Well, in general, I can just look at where that right endpoint is and where the left endpoint is and just subtract, in this case, those x values, right? And that'll give me the length of any one of those lines. So I'm doing right minus left, right? Right endpoint minus left endpoint, and I just said those would be x values. So what I need to do then is I need to actually solve my equations so they're not y equals a function of x, but rather x equals some function of y. So let's do that. We can start over here with y equals x. Well, that's pretty simple, right? Y equals x, x equals y. That's the same either way. But for y equals x squared, I need to actually solve that. So y equals x squared, I can write that as x equals plus or minus the square root of y. Okay, so I've got kind of two pieces there, so the question is which piece am I dealing with here? Well, the piece I'm dealing with here is positive, right? Positive x values. So it's going to be this positive root. So x equals root y is another way I could write that. So then I can write an expression for the side of the square doing the right function minus a left function, and I'm going to get root y minus y. So hopefully now you see why it makes sense that in this case we're going to be integrating with respect to y. So whenever your cross sections are perpendicular to the y-axis and you have to do right minus left, then you're going to be integrating with respect to y. Okay, so I've got my side of the square. So then now I can go ahead and actually write down that area function, and it's just simply side squared. So root y minus y quantity squared is the area of one of these square cross sections. So that takes care of what's inside my integral. Now the only thing left to find are the bounds on my integral. And if I look at my picture, I can see I could find those by doing some intersections. Okay? And what I can do is I can actually take this, what we just found, x equals y and x equals root y, set them equal to each other, and those will give me the appropriate y values for the intersections. So y equals square root of y. I can square both sides here and get y squared equals y, or y squared minus y equals 0, which I can write as y times y minus 1 equals 0. So we get y equals 0 and y equals 1. And that looks about right graphically. So here's a y value of 0, here's a y value of 1. Right, and since I'm integrating with respect to y, it's important that I do use y values for the bounds on my integral. Okay, so now I'm ready to actually completely set up my integral. I have all the pieces I need. So the volume is the integral from y equals 0 to y equals 1 of the area of one of these squares, which we said was square root of y minus y quantity squared dy. So let's go ahead and quickly evaluate this integral really quick. This one's not too messy, relatively speaking. So the first thing we're going to want to do is just FOIL this expression out. So expand the inside of this integral. And if I do that, it looks like I get y minus, so root y times y is y to the 3/2, and I have two of those terms, so minus 2y to the 3/2 plus y squared. And then I can go ahead and find the antiderivative of that. And I get 1/2 y squared minus 2. And then this is going to give me y to the 5/2 over 5/2. So I can write that as 2 times 2/5 y to the 5/2. And then plus 1/3 y cubed. And this is going to be evaluated from 0 to 1. So this is 1/2 y squared minus 4/5 y to the 5/2 plus 1/3 y cubed evaluated from 0 to 1. So if I plug in 1, I'm going to get 1/2 minus 4/5 plus 1/3 and then minus 0. Right? If I plug in 0, I just get 0. So I just have 1/2 minus 4/5 plus 1/3, and if you work that out, you should get the fraction 1 over 30. And that 1 over 30 is the volume of the solid that was described in the directions.